Good day from ChemHelp ASAP. Now, if you've watched all these bonding videos as a playlist, then you've seen a lot of background information. We're finally going to put this information together to draw some molecules, and we'll start with something simple, methane. Okay, on the screen we have methane written as a word. We have the Lewis dot representation of methane, and we have another representation that shows it as an sp3 hybridized carbon, and then the hydrogens coming off with bond angles of 109.5 and the tetrahedral geometry. So let's see this as an orbital picture. So we know we have a carbon, and this carbon is going to have sp3 hybrids coming off of it, and we'll really draw them very, very much like this picture in the upper right of the tetrahedral carbon. And so when I draw two of these lobes, they're going to be out of plane. One is going to be coming on top of the plane that's meant to be kind of bolded, and that one's a little dotted. And these are going to these sp3 hybrids interact with hydrogen atoms and their s orbitals. And we'll make that one a little darker. And this one will be all dotted, kind of hidden behind that other. And if you wanted to, you could try to put, there are two lone pairs in each of these spots. It's a little bit unnecessary. But as you can see, we're trying to represent what the orbitals are doing. Now these pictures, when we start putting in these types of bonds, and each of these is a sigma bond, these pictures get very messy. As a result, the good news is we don't typically draw sigma bonds and show them as lobes and or overlapping orbitals. We simply stick to this picture on the right, this nice, simple, streamlined hybridization picture that shows the geometry and the bond angles. But it's still important to remember, when you see this picture on the right, this nice, simple sp3 hybridized carbon, this is really what it represents with these orbitals. And remember, each one of these sigma bonds, we're taking two atomic orbitals. What are those atomic orbitals? We're taking an sp3 from the carbon plus an s orbital from the hydrogen. And what do we get out? When we mix these together, we get two molecular orbitals. We get our sigma, our low energy sigma orbital, and our sigma star. The electrons, of course, are in the sigma orbital. So this is an orbital picture of methane. You won't typically see people drawing orbital pictures of methanes or showing orbitals to represent sigma bonds, because they just kind of muck up your picture. It gets messy. But it's important that we understand in our head that these are, when we draw these simplified structures, orbitals are present, and they're what hold the molecule together for our sigma bonds.